Good evening, everyone. Dear colleagues, dear students, dear guests. I have to say that I was struggling to say a few words about this introduction or to open this great opportunity we have tonight. And why is that? Because normally I should be very happy. I am surrounded by many more compatriots than usual, but in fact, it is a bit complicated to speak in the introduction of this particular choir. First of all, I was looking for the right wording. I was looking for the type of wording to introduce such a opportunity. I'm still using the neutral opportunity because usually we are calling it as a concert or a performance, but in reality, this is a prayer. This is what we are going to experience tonight. They are not just simply perform something. They are just helping us. They are here to help us to pray, to deepen our prayers for the next, I don't know, maybe 1 hour. With that being said, now I can really dig into the introduction. It is my great pleasure to introduce a Psaltic Group, Byzantine choir from Romania, Bucharest, actually the official choir of the Patriarchal Cathedral in Bucharest. This was founded back in 1997. I'm sure many of you already Googled them. You know that they have their own YouTube channel and you know their history. It's a group that evolved throughout these more than two decades. They prayed in so many cathedrals and churches, both in Romania and abroad. They are not for the first time here in the United States. They already visited in this 2 week trip, a part of the Midwest, and now they are here with us on the East Coast. Another direction, another topic that I would approach tonight is that we already had a kind of a hint. This is a Byzantine choir. So this is the style they are helping us to pray. I know that there's a tension between a mixed choir or using multiple voices or tones and the Byzantine choir. We feel that a little bit of attention here, but this is the beauty of Pan-Orthodoxy, and this is the beauty that I experienced back home in Romania, and this is the beauty that I continue to experience here at St. Vladimir's. I remember my time at the seminary at the beginning of, right after the fall of communism, at the beginning of 1990s, when everything, it was that type of choir with multiple voices, sometimes, you know, male at the seminary level, at the university, we all experienced that big choir of Father Nicu Moldoveanu, more than 200 students and so on. But little by little, towards the beginning of 1990s, probably they were pushing for a clear getting back to the Byzantine tradition in Romanian circles, Romanian ecclesiastical circles. Towards the end of the 1990s, we experienced in more and more Romanian Orthodox parish churches the beauty of Byzantine music. And that would not simply state a dismantling of the other choir music, but they were just going both hand in hand. And I remember that, and still is the fact in the Patriarchal Cathedral in Bucharest, that they are singing part of the service, and there is also a mixed choir, very famous as well, doing the liturgy. So this is the beauty of Orthodoxy. This is the beauty of what we experience here. A few words about St. Vladimir's and our experience, music experience at St. Vladimir's. When I landed here in October 2018, everything, it was much more into choir, into different tonalities and voices, and just a little bit into Byzantine. Little by little, being helped in that transitioning by our excellent, skilled students, led right now by Deacon Nicholas Fine. We also had the privilege to experience at least one day a week for the two services we are praying every day in this very chapel. We're experiencing the Byzantine tonality, and all of our students now are exposed to both styles of prayer. The relations that this particular seminary has with Romania are, I would describe it, extraordinary, because if we are looking back to our origin back in 1938 and trying to dig into each and every decade, there were multiple students, there were multiple guests that were invited to speak here. I'm just mentioning Father Roman Braga or Father Calci Dumitrasa, Father Vasile Vasilache, before the fall of communism or right after the fall of communism. After that, it was obviously much easier for the Romanians to find their way to St. Vladimir's. And this transition is expressed in two multiple ways. We just mentioned the connection with guests and students, but obviously there are some couple of professors now with Romanian theological education. And more than that, I think SBS Press is doing a great service to promoting Romanian theology. One translation from Father Dumitru Stanilae was published by SBS Press. Now we are working actually on several multiple books. I don't think it's necessarily because of my presence or because of Father Bogdan Bucur's presence, but it's just something that developed in time. And recently, we published this year a very important volume in the Orthodox Profile series that was dedicated to my patriarch, Patriarch Daniel. Father Chad Hatfield, our president, is the series editor, and he edited this volume. And this is going to be expanded into a series of new publications. One would be the Journal of Joy, the famous Journal of Joy of Father Nicolae Steinhardt. We are also working right now on publishing a journal by Father Roman Braga. So the connections are getting stronger and stronger with Romania. That prayer that I promised in the beginning of my short introduction is going to be somehow divided into three parts tonight. The first part will be delivered by our own Byzantine small choir, led by Deacon Nicholas Fine. Then we'll have a kind of a, let me use a proper word here, an intermezzo with our septet, not octet, not quartet, but a septet, led by Dr. Harrison Russin. And then we will have our guests, somehow as a corollary of this night. All of them are just selected excellent, extraordinary troparia and church hymns. And I am pretty sure that you all will be led to a very deep prayer tonight. I will give the floor right now to Deacon Nicholas to start that, and each and every minute you'll feel that calling for prayer. Thank you all tonight. You are very welcome. Bine ați venit. We are very happy to have you here, and it's a blessing for us. Deacon Nicholas.
Thank you, Dr. Tudoria, for that introduction. We'll be singing two pieces this evening, the Doxastikon of the Praises for the Exaltation of the Cross, as well as the Ninth Ode, Katavasia.
Glory to the
Crucified.
We've also chosen three pieces for the Feast of Exaltation. This first is a setting in three voices of the Expostolarium, the Hymn of Light, the tone three melody, harmonized in three voices by one of the more colorful figures of 20th century Russian Orthodox Church music history, Johann or Ivan Gardner.
The cross is the guardian of the whole earth. The cross is the beauty of the church. The cross is the strength of our Christians. The
Our next selection is setting of one of these Stihira at the Veneration of the Cross, which comes at the end of the Matin service. This is an arrangement of the melody Thou Hast Given a Sign, arranged for male choir by Vladimir Morrison.
Come, ye faithful, and let us then array for life-giving.
And our final selection is a setting of the communion hymn for Fridays, which commemorates the cross. It's a setting by Pavel Chesnokov, Russian composer from the beginning of the 20th century, of a Kievan chant melody. The text is from the 74th or 73rd Psalm. Salvation is created in the midst of the earth, O God, hallelujah. Now it's my great pleasure to introduce Archdeacon Mihail and the Tronos Ensemble.
Oh.
Oh, Lord, Savadunat cu Dumnezeu.
Thank you.
Bucurastie lăudată, născătoare de Dumnezeu. Dumnezeu, ci cu mergător înainte și cu toți sfinții scăpare solește-ne. Cu toate oșirile îngerești, cu botezătorul, cu apostolii lui Hristos și cu sfinții toți Fecioară Maică, necetat mântuire, solește-ne.
Pe fereastră el cătat
și am marse spăimântat.
Dragii mei, coborniți, lăsați somnul, vă treziți, armele vile gătiți, că pe noi ne-a înconjurat așa cel păcat. Ieniceri cu tunuri mari ce sparg ziduri cât de tari. Vine vorba rost mârșat, turci în casă năvărat,
se minuna și cu milă te crea.
Brâncovene, Constantin,
we can hardly refrain ourselves from a big round of applause. We'll do that once we get over to the reception at Jermak following. We'll all want to thank our distinguished guests, Archdeacon Mihai, and these magnificent voices. It was really our blessing to have you here, to have these voices now mixed with a multitude of angels and saints and others within the confines of this particular chapel. We really were sort of lifted and carried, as Dr. Todoria said, not as in a concert, but we were enveloped in prayer through your incredible, incredible way of presenting the Byzantine tradition, especially as it's sort of taken on its own kind of Romanian flavor there tonight. So absolutely beautiful, bravo. And to our own, again, you shined like the stars of heaven, and you make us all very proud. So I thank all of you, Deacon Nicholas and Dr. Russin, for your part tonight. You may be interested in knowing there are over 200 people who are actually listening virtually. I'm a former parish priest in Kansas, and if you don't know where Kansas is, it's when you make the sign of the cross over the United States, it's where the things intersect. I had lots of Romanian parishioners in Kansas, and they all have contacted me today saying, we're all listening tonight. So voices were heard literally all over America by over 200 people. So we enjoyed the evening. We look forward to getting to know you, and we invite you to join us all now for a reception on the Jermak porch. So again, not the book.